Good morning to everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta and this is our second lecture on class 12, chapter 5, exercise 5.2. We already solved the question number 1 to question number 11. Now we are going to take question number 12. Before to start the video, I request to everyone, please listen to me carefully and watch the video from start to end. Please read the statement. What is the statement number 12? What it states? An invertible matrix A satisfying this condition. It means we have a matrix which is invertible matrix. And you know what's the invertible matrix? We already explained the concept is A into B, which is equal to B into A, which is equal to I. If such a relation exists, then you can say that A is your invertible matrix and B is equal to inverse of A. I already explained it. If A into B, which is equal to B into A, is equal to I. If any matrix follow these relations, then we called A is an invertible matrix and B is called inverse of A. So you can write it as B is equal to A inverse, and what is A? A is our invertible matrix. We already discussed this concept in our first video. If you still not watch my first video, so please go to my playlist and watch my first video. Now give an expression. It means we have to give an expression to find the A inverse. Please make a read the statements, because in this no matrix is specified, so we have to find the expression in terms of the matrices A but not define its elements. And how we can do this? We know A satisfies this condition, and we know if any solution satisfies any equation, it means if we put, we substitute that in the equation, then left hand side becomes equal to right hand side. It said that if A satisfies this equation, means A is the solution of the this equation. So if we replace X by A, it satisfies the equation. This is the meaning of satisfactions of A of this equations. So I can write as X square minus 5x plus 7 is equal to 0, and A is solution of this equation. It implies if we replace X by A, it satisfies the condition. That's why I am replacing X by A. What we will put here, we got A square minus 5 into A plus 7 is equal to 0. Now what is A? A is your invertible matrix, and you know this is your A invertible matrix. It means this is a matrix, this is a matrix, and now 7 is your number, so it must be a matrix. Now, how we can represent 7 as 7 into I, because if any number are specified in the equation, it means it is connected with the unit or identity matrix. So you can write it as A square minus 5 into A plus 7 into I is equal to 0. The order of the identity matrix should be equal to the order of the A matrix. Please keep it in your minds. According to the equations, the identity matrix has the same order. Now we have to use this expression and we have to find the A inverse expression. So how we can do? So please again revise your concepts and properties of the inverse. What's the property of the inverse is? First property is, if we multiply a matrix with its inverse, we get an identity matrix. Or you can change the order. If we multiply inverse matrix with the matrix, then the result also will be same, which is equal to I. And please keep it in mind, but in the multiplication of other matrix like A into B, the result not be equal to B into A. But in this case, if we multiply A matrix with its inverse, or we change the order A inverse into A, the result should be identity matrix. It means the order of inverse and with its matrix is not matter. Now our second property is what? If we multiply any matrices, either 2 into 2, 3 into 2, whatever the matrix, if we multiply it with identity matrix, we get the same matrix. It means if we multiply any matrix with the identity matrix, the elements of the matrix should not be changed. We get the same matrix. Means A into I is equal to I into A, which is equal to A. These are the two important properties that you have to use in remaining questions of the exercise 5.2. Please make a note. Now we have to use the same concept here. The first step, because such type of question it can be easily solved by using some steps. Our first step is step 1. Please write the highest power of the matrix A on one side and take the remaining terms on the right hand side. So in this, the highest power of matrices is A square. So we get A square on one side and we will take the remaining terms on the right hand side. So if I change minus 5A into 5A on the right hand side, it becomes positive 5A and this becomes negative 7 into I. Now we have to find the A inverse, but in this no term is like in terms of A inverse. So how we get the A inverse? You have to do second step. Multiply by A inverse. You have to do multiplications on the both side by A inverse. Now what we get the results? Now do multiply A inverse multiply A square, and we can write A square means A into A. Now same here, A inverse is multiply 5 into A minus A inverse multiply 7 into I. Now if I solve, because A into B into C, it means multiplication of the three matrix follow the associative rules. We can solve any two matrix, either we have to solve first and two matrix and then the result is multiplied with the third matrix, or you can solve second and third matrix first and then the result is multiplied one with second and third. You can do same. So in this I am going to multiply A inverse into A, and this is A. I am taking multiplication of first two matrix, A inverse into A. Now as you know, 5 is what? 5 is a scalar number, and you know the scalar number can be written anywhere, either in left hand side or right hand side or middle. You can move either sides because it doesn't affect the matrix because it's a scalar number. That's why I'm moving this on the left hand side. I will got A inverse into A. Same here, I move 7 here, A inverse into I. Now we have to use these properties. A into A inverse, which is equal to I. Please make a note here, A inverse into A, which is equal to I. So we replace it I into A. Now same here, 5. A into A inverse, again we replace by it I. Now what? A inverse into I, second property. If you multiply, this is here A, and but in this case is A inverse. A is a matrix and A inverse is also a matrix. I said any matrix is multiplied with the identity matrix, you get the same matrix. So it means if we multiply this matrix to the identity matrix, we get the same matrix, we get A inverse. Now please make a look, because we have to calculate the A inverse and we get the A inverse here. So it means we have to find out the values of A inverse expressions. So solve it and take one side A inverse and the remaining terms we have to move on the other sides. Then what will be value? This is minus 7 A inverse. If I move it on the one side, I get here 7 A inverse. Now move this on the right hand side. What I got? 5 into I minus I into A. And again, please note, 5 is your scalar number, so we have to write as it is. But I into A, again the properties, I into A, identity matrix with multiplication of A matrix, we get the same matrix. 5 into I as it is. Now I into A is replaced by A. Now what will be the result? We have to calculate the A inverse. That's why I have to move 7 on the right hand side. And what will be the value? A inverse is equal to 1 by 7 5i minus A. You can separate them. A inverse is equal to 5 by 7 into I minus 1 by 7 into A. This is the expression for the A inverse. It's very simple. So keep it in mind these two properties and we have to calculate A inverse very quickly. So please make a note first. Now I am going to take our next question, question number 30. Please read the statement. Show that A is this matrix, satisfy these equations, and hence find A inverse. This is very, very important because such type of question is most probable asked in your final exams. So please note this. How we can do this? In such type of question, you have to do in two steps. First step is you have to prove this equation. This is your first part. Then you have to calculate A inverse, not directly by using cofactor method. You have to use this equation to find the A inverse. I again repeat the question. You have to do such type of question in two parts. First part is you have to prove these equations. Then your second part is use this equation and find out the values for A inverse. This is similar to as we did in our first question of this lecture. So do our first part. First part is because it satisfies this. It means it's a solution for this equation. So how we can write it as x square plus 4x minus 42 is equal to 0. A satisfied. We have to check or show. It means first question is, please make a read. Show that. It means we have to show first. This is our first part. It means we have to do first satisfy, check either satisfy or not. Let A satisfy. Then if A satisfies this equation, it's a solution of the equation. So we can write as A square plus 4 into A minus 42. Again, the A is your matrix and 42 is your scalar number. It means we have to connect it with identity matrix. So that's why I am writing here I, which is equal to 0. Now we have to solve this and prove this. How we can write as A square means A into A. So I am writing A into A plus 4a means 4 into a minus 42 into I, and we have to prove it on which is equal to 0. That's why I am taking left hand side. Now put the values. A is what? A is minus 8, 2, 5, 4. Again A, minus 8, 5, 2, 4. Now plus 4 into A. A is what? Minus 8, 5, 2, 4. Minus 42 into I. What is identity matrix? 1, 0, 0, 1. Now solve this. Firstly, minus 8 into minus 8, we get 64. 5 into 10, we get 10. Minus 8 into 5, minus 40. 5 into 4, 20. 2 into minus 8, minus 16. 4 into 2, 8. 2 into 5, 10. 4 into 4, 16. Now multiply this, because this is a matrix and we are doing multiplication, so 4 is multiplied with the all the elements, because this is a matrix, not a determinant. Please make a note this. 4 into minus 8 minus 32, 4 into 5 20, 4 into 2 8, 4 into 4 16. Now multiply this. 42 into 1 42, 0 0, 42 into 1 42. Now solve this. 64 plus 10, 74, minus 4, 20, minus 8, 26, plus, if we solve this, minus 32 and minus 42, we get minus 2 to 4, 4 or 3, or you can write as it is, minus 32, 20, 8, 16, minus 42, 0, 0, 42. We solve this in our next step. Now solve this, all these matrix. First we have 74 plus minus minus 32 minus 42. Next element is minus 20 plus 20 minus 0. Next one is minus 8 plus 8 minus 0. Now plus 26 plus 16 minus 42. Now what's the result? 32 and 42, 74. 74 minus 74, we get 0. 20 minus 20, we get 0. Minus 8 plus 8, we get 0. 16 plus 26, 42 minus 42, we get 0, which is equal to our right hand side. We have to prove. It means we are proof. We did our first part. Now what we have to do? We have to do its second part. In second part, it means we have to find A inverse. It means we have to use these equations. I am doing here our second part as A square plus 4A minus 42 into I is equal to 0. Because this satisfies all the equation. Because it satisfied. Now what we have to do? Step 1. We have to take the highest power of the matrix on the one side and take the remaining terms on the other sides. We get here A square, of which is highest power. Now I am moving minus 42i is equals to plus 42i, and this becomes minus 4 into A. Our second step is multiply by A inverse. Multiply by A inverse on both sides. A inverse, how we can write A square is A into A. Now here also minus A inverse, 42 into I minus A inverse into 4A. So if we solve this, A into A inverse is equal to I, and A into I is equal to A. We are using this property. By using property, Now A inverse into A, we get I into A, which is equal to, now we can replace or we can move 42 on the left hand side. What's the result? A inverse into I into I. Now same here, move 4 on the left side, we get A inverse into A. Now what's the result? I into A, identity matrix multiplied with A, we get the A matrices, we get A. Now 42 as it is, A inverse into I, again the identity matrices multiplied with A inverse matrix, we get A inverse. Now same, A inverse into A, which is equal to I, so 42 I. Now please solve, we have to find the values of A inverse, so we have to move minus 42 on the left hand side, we get A minus 42 I, which is equal to A inverse. Now we have to solve this, because A is already given. So make a note first, then we do our next part of this question. Please do a correction here. What we do, because we have to calculate A inverse, what we did do, mistake, we did mistake here. We have to calculate A inverse. Then what we have to do, firstly we have to move this minus 40 I on the left hand side. So we get A plus 42 I, which is equal to 42 A inverse. Then what's the values of A inverse is? A inverse is equal to A plus 42 I and divided by 42, because I am moving this 42 on the left hand side. Now solve this, 1 by 42. Now we have to solve A. A is what? Minus 8524 plus 42, and which is equal to 1001. Now solve this, 1 by 42. Now solve it, minus 8524, this is equal to 420042. 1 by 42. Now solve this, minus 8 plus 42, 5 plus 0, 2 plus 0, and 4 plus 42. We got 1 by 42 minus 8 plus 42, which is equal to 34. This is 2, this is 5, this is 46. So please check it. Sorry, once again, we did mistake here. This is A inverse into 4 into A. 4 into A inverse into A. I write it as a 42, but it is not. It is what? This is I into A is A, which is equal to 42. A inverse into I, which is A inverse minus 4. A inverse into A, which is I. So if we move this, A plus 4 into I, which is equal to 42 A inverse. And what's the value of A inverse will be? 1 by 42 A plus 4 I. So in this we have 4, not 42. Do particular 4 into 1, 4. So I'm rubbing this portion. 1 by 42 minus 8, 5, 2, 4 plus 4 into 1, 4, 0, 0, 4. 1 by 42 minus 8 plus 4, 5 plus 0, 2 plus 0, 4 plus 4. We got 1 by 42 minus 8 plus 4 minus 4, 5 2 A. Please make a note. Now I am going to take another question which is similar as we already did as first. For the matrices A, show that it means we have to first prove this and then find hence A inverse. It means this question is similar to as first. Now you have to do it yourself by using practice. I am going here so you can start it yourself. Firstly, what we have to prove? A cube minus 6 into a square plus 5 into a plus 11 into i3. This is our left hand side. And now a3 can be written as a into a into a. So I am writing here a into a minus 6 into a into a. This is written 5 into a and this is written as 11 into i3. Now put all this value and start to solve. What is a? 1 1 2 1 2 minus 1 1 minus 3 3. A 1 1 2 1 2 minus 1 1 minus 3 3. A square into A into A. Firstly, I have calculated A square, then I will calculate it A cube, then after that I am going to put all these values in the equation number 1. So it becomes very easy. If I will take simultaneously, it becomes very lengthy. So not try to do simultaneously. Firstly, you have to calculate A square, then you have to calculate A cube. Now then put all the values. So I'm here firstly calculating A square. So do it. We get 1 into 1, 1, 1 into 1, 1, 1 into 2, 2. Now 1 into 1, 1, 1 into 2, 2, 1 into minus 1, minus 1, 1 into 1, 1, 1 into minus 3, minus 3, 1 into 3, 3. 1 into 1, 1, 2 into 1, 2, minus 3 into 2, minus 6. 1 into 1, 1, 2 into 2, 4, minus 3 into minus 1, plus 3. 1 into 1, 1, 2 into minus 3, minus 6, minus 3 into 3, 9. Now 2 into 1, 2, plus minus 1 into 1, minus 1, 3 into 2, 6. 2 into 1, 2, minus 1 into 2, minus 2, 3 into minus 1, minus 3. 2 into 1, 2, minus 1 into minus 3, plus 3, 3 into 3, 9. Now solve this. 2 plus 1, 3 plus 1, 4. 1 plus 2, 3 minus 6, minus 3. 2 plus 6, 8 minus 1, 7. 1 plus 2, 3 minus 1, 2. 4 plus 1, 5 plus 3, 8. 2 minus 2, 0, minus 3. 3 minus 3, 0, 1. 9 plus 1, 10 minus 6, 4. 9, 3, 12, 2, 14. Please make a check. Sorry, we did a mistake here. Now, we have multiplied 1 into 1, 1. 2 into minus 3, minus 6. And minus 3 into 3, minus 9. So 9 and 6, 15 minus 1, minus 14. This is your A square. Now you have to calculate A cube. A cube means A square into A. What is A square? 4 minus 3, 7, 2, 8 minus 3, 1 minus 14, 14. What is A is? 1, 1, 1, 1, 2 minus 3, 2 minus 1. 3. Now do it yourself. I write very shortly. Please make up now. after multiplication you will got, you can verify as yourselves. We get a cube is this and we get a square is this. Now we have to put a square and a cube in equations 1. So try to do yourselves. I am rubbing this portion. So I put all the values. A cube is this minus 6 into a square is this plus 5 into a. A is this plus 11 into i3. i3 is equal to 110. Now do firstly you have to multiply 6 with these elements, 5 into these elements, and 11 into these elements. Now then add all these elements, you will get result 0. So do it yourself. After multiplication you will got this. I solve this, so please make a note first. Why I do this with another question? Because its question is very easy, but the main problem is it's very lengthy. We have to do more calculations, more have to addition, so this becomes very lengthy. That's why I solve it by yourself. So please make a note first. We prove our right side. Now we have to do our second part. And please make a note why I am taking this question, because such type of this question is very very important. It's asked many times in your final exam. That's why I try to solve this question in this video. Now we have to do its second part. It means we have to use this, because we prove this result. We prove. So we have to use this result and we have to find the A inverse. Now do the same step. Firstly we have to separate the highest power on one side and the remaining part on the other side. A cube, this minus 6 is becomes positive 6 square minus 5 A minus 11 I 3. Now second step is what? Multiply by inverse. Multiply by A inverse on both sides. We get A inverse into A cube. A cube can be written as A into A into A, which is A inverse 6 into A square. A square can be written as A into A minus A inverse into 5 into A minus A inverse into 11 into I 3. Now if we solve this, A inverse into A is equal to I, and A into I, which is also A, and A inverse into I, which is also equal to minus A inverse. Now use these results. We get A inverse A into, we get I A into A as it is, which is equal to, this is 6, 6 is scalar number, so we can move on the left hand side. It becomes A inverse into A into A. Same here I move 5 on the left hand side, it becomes A inverse into A. Now move 11 A inverse into I 3. Now solve this. If we multiply A into A, it's a matrix. If multiply with identity, it gives same. It means we get only A into A. Now same here. A into A inverse is I. I into A minus 5. A inverse into A, we get I minus 11. A inverse into I, which gives us A inverse. It means here we got A square 6 I into A is A minus 5 I minus 11 A inverse. It means we got A inverse. Now we have to separate A inverse and move the other sides on terms on the other sides. So this is negative, I am moving it on the left hand side. 11 A inverse is equal to 6 into a minus 5 into I, and it becomes minus a square. Then what will be a inverse is 1 by 11, 6 into a minus 5 into I minus a square. Now we have to put all these values. 6 into a, what is a is 1, 1, 2, 1, 2 minus 1, 1 minus 3, 3 minus 5 into I, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1 minus a square. A square is what? Please make a first note. So I am put the values of a square here. Now it's very easy, because firstly we have to multiply 6 with this matrix, then we have to multiply 5 with this matrix and this, and we have to simplify and we get the values of a inverse. So do it yourself. Now please make a note. After simplification and multiplication you will got this result. This is the final a inverse. Please make a note. Our next question is question number 18. It's same as first. For the matrix A, find the number A and B. It means firstly we have to determine the number A and B, then such that, it means this equation is satisfied. So it means we have to, there is no need to prove this because it is already proved. But we have to use this result because A and B we have to calculate. Then our second part is the same, we have to find A inverse. So we have to use this. A square means A into A plus A into A plus B into I, which is equal to 0. Now solve this. What's the value of A is 3, 1, 2, 1. 3, 1, 2, 1. Again put the values of A. A is what? 3, 1, 2, 1 plus B, 1, 0, 0, 1, and we get 0. 0 means 0 matrix, which is also called null matrix, which has all elements is equal to 0. So we have to put 0, 0, 0, 0. Now solve this and get the values of A and B. Multiply 3 into 3, 9. 2 into 1, 2. 3 into 2, 6. 2 into 1, 2. 1 into 3, 3. 1 into 1, 1. 1 into 2, 2. 1 into 1, 1. Now multiply this A. A into 3, 3A. 2 into A, A into A. Now do multiplication here. B into 1, B, 0, 0, B, which is equal to 0, 0, 0, 0. Now solve this. 9 plus 2, 11, plus 3 into A, plus B. 6 plus 2, 8, plus 2 into A, plus 0, 3 plus 1, 4, plus A, plus 0. 2 plus 1, 3, plus A, plus B, which is equal to 0, 0, 0. Now these two matrices are equal and we can equate corresponding elements over are also equal. Now we have to calculate the values of A. It's very simple because this is your 4 plus A. If we equate this, equal to 0. What's the values of A is? Minus 4. Now we have to calculate the values of B. Use this equation. 3 plus A plus B is equal to 0. Now 3 plus, what's the value of A is? Minus 4 plus B is equal to 0. Minus 1 plus B means B is equal to 1. So we get the values of A is minus 4 and B is 1. So please make a note first, then we do our next part. Please make a note. We got A is equal to minus 4 and B is equal to minus 1. Now put it in our equation. a square minus 4 into a plus 1, because b value is equal to 1, is equal to 0. Our step is, first we have to take our highest power on one side and the remaining power on the right hand side. We get minus 4a becomes plus 4a minus I. Second step is multiply by a inverse on both sides. What we will got? A inverse into a square can be written as a into a, which is a inverse 4 into a minus a inverse into I. Now we can do it short. A inverse into a, which is equal to I. A as it is. Now we can move 4 on the left hand side. What we will got? A inverse into a, which is also I. Now this, if a inverse is multiplied with identity, we got only a inverse. Now we have to calculate a inverse. Move this on the left hand side. We get a inverse is equal to 4 into I. And this, if I solve this further, I into a is what? A. So 4 into I minus a inverse. Now move this. A inverse, which is equal to 4 I minus a. Now what is I? 1001. And what is a? 3121. Now solve this. 4004 minus 3121. What's the result? 4 minus 3, 1, 0 minus 2, minus 2, 0 minus 1, minus 1, 4 minus 1, 3. It means we got A inverse is equal to 1 minus 2 minus 1, 3. Please make a note first. Now we are doing our next question. Question number is 19. It is something different, but it's very easy. How we can do this question, please keep it in mind. In this we have to find a matrix X multiplying with 3 this matrix, and we get the this result. Such type of question we already did in our first third chapter. But this question can be done in two ways. But the main important point is what we have to do in this, because it's not a single question, it's a different types of questions. You can do it as a two types, but the other questions, it's very typical to do two types. There is only one method to do such type of question. I am giving in a two way explanation, but the most important is what we have to do first. Please make a note. Firstly, you have to do let the matrices, which is already given. It means we have given this matrix. So I am taking let. I am giving its name is as A. I am assigning this matrix as a A. So we get A is 3, 1, 2, minus 1. And I am giving a name this matrix as a B. We get 4, 2, 1, 3. So this becomes what? X, it becomes A, which is equal to B. This is our first step. Which for your first step is what? Whatever the matrix, it is 2, 3, 4 and so on, whatever. You give its name A, B, C, D and so on. After that, you replace the matrix with its name. This is our first step. Now what we have to do in our second step? We have to find the undefined matrix. What is undefined matrix is X. It means we have to calculate X. So what we have to do in this, please keep it in mind, we have to do separate X. But here the matrix A is connected with this. So how we can do separate? We know, because if A into A inverse is I, so if we multiply A inverse on both sides, then A inverse into A becomes I. an identity matrix is multiplied with any matrix, we get same matrix. It means we can do in this manner to separate X. So do keep it in mind. This step is very, very important. Now multiply by A inverse on both sides. Then what will be the result? Now third step is, keep it in mind, you have to do multiplications and according to its order. If you do multiply on left hand side, then both you have to do multiply on left hand side. If you do multiply on right hand side, then you have to do multiplication on both of side on the right hand side. I have to remove A, so it means we have to multiply A inverse on the right hand side. So order we cannot be changed. So if this is multiplied with A inverse, we are taking A inverse on the right hand side. So in this case we also take the order on right hand side. We cannot take it here A inverse into B, that the portion becomes wrong. You have to do it on the right hand side. Both the terms are same, not to have to change the order. Now what is A into A inverse, which is equal to I, we already did. Now B into A inverse, and now X into I, which is equal to X. So X is B into A inverse. This is the most important step. Now if we want to calculate the matrix X, then what we have to do? We have to do only the multiplications B into A inverse, and we already know what is B, but we don't know A inverse. It means firstly we have to calculate A inverse, and we can be used adjoint for this method to calculate the A inverse. I am using shortcut to find out the A inverse. You know what the shortcut is? This is your A matrix. Then what's the inverse is? A inverse is adjoint of A divided by determinant of A. You keep it in mind, not do it in your fair notebook. I am doing it here fast, so that's why I am doing shortcut, and you have to do complete way. Now what's the adjoint is? You have to interchange the elements. We got minus 1, 3, and the sign of the remaining terms will change, minus 2, minus 1. And what's the determinant? 3 into minus 1, minus 3. Minus 2 into 1, 2. We got minus 3, minus 2. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 1, 3. And this becomes minus 5. Now if we divide by minus, then what will be the elements? 1 by 5. Sign will be changed. 1, 1, 2, minus 3. This is what? Our A inverse. It's very easy to find out A inverse using shortcut method. Now put all these values. X is what? B. B is what? 4, 2, 1, 3. Now we have to do multiplication A inverse, and this is your scalar number, so we can write it in left hand sides. I am writing here 1 by 1. What is 1, 2, 1, minus 3. Now solve this. 1 by 5. 4 into 1, 4. 1 into 1, 1. 4 into 2, 8. 1 into minus 3, minus 3. 2 into 1, 2. 3 into 1, 3. 2 into 2, 4. 3 into minus 3, minus 9. Which is equal to 1 by 5. 4 plus 1, 5. 8 minus 3, 5. 2 plus 3, 5. 4 minus 9, minus 5. If we divide by 5, what we will get? 1, 1, 1, minus 1. This is our X. So it's very easy. So keep it in mind, but we have to do it two steps. Please make a note. Now I am going to next question, question number 20, which is same as we did first. So it is basically for your practice, because its type of question is new. Now we have to find the matrix X, so we have to do same step. First we have to do let. I am giving this name as A, this name is B, and this name is C. Then what's the expression becomes? A x B is equal to C. This is our expression. I'm considering A is what? A is our 3, 2, 7, 5. B is what? Minus 1, minus 2, 1, 1. And C is what? 2, 0, minus 1, 4. Now, what we have to do? We have to do separate X matrix. So, in this, we have two matrix connected with A, X. So, we have to do one by one. First, we remove the matrix A. So, we have to do multiplication by A inverse on both sides. Multiply by A inverse on both sides. So now A is on left hand side. So I am taking A inverse on the left hand side of both this term. A inverse A x into B, which is equal to A inverse into C. Now this is what? It becomes I x B, which is equal to A inverse C. Now what is identity matrix into any matrix? We get the same matrix. So we get X. X into B is equal to A inverse C. Now what we have to do? Now we have to remove the matrix B. So that's why we have to do multiplications by B inverse on both sides. Multiply by B inverse on both side. X into B, we are doing right hand side because B is on right hand side. So I am doing multiplication B inverse on right hand side. A inverse C into B inverse. Now what is this? X into I, which is equal to A inverse C into B inverse. Again X into identity matrix, we get X matrix. A inverse C into B inverse. It means if we want to calculate X, then what we have to do? We have to do multiplications of these three matrix. First we have to calculate A inverse, then we have to calculate B inverse, then we have to do multiplications. So we are using shortcut method. What is A? Now what's the A inverse is? Adjoint of A divided by determinant of A. What's the adjoints? Interchange the diagonal elements. 5, 3. And change the sign. Minus 2, minus 7. Divide by determinants. 3 into 5, 15. Minus 7 into 2, 14. We got 5 minus 2 minus 7, 3. 14 minus 14, 1. It means we get A inverse is equal to 5 minus 2 minus 7, 3. We have to do same B inverse. B inverse is what? Adjoint of B divided by determinant of B. Now solve this. B is what? This. Change the diagonal elements. 1, minus 1. And remove. Change the sign. Minus 1 and plus 2. Now what's the determinant? Minus 1 into 1? Minus 1. Minus. Minus 2 into 1? Minus 2. So we get 1, minus 1, 2, minus 1. And this becomes minus 1 plus 2. So we get B inverse is equal to 1 minus 1, 2 minus 1, because it becomes minus 1 plus 2, 1. So the result will be same. Now we already got A inverse, B inverse and C. Now take it in order and do multiple. Please do it yourself. So now I am going to take our next question. Question number is 21. What we have to do? We have to prove that. So it is simplest. The main point is it is in terms of not a number, in terms of trigonometric function. So you have to use trigonometry as we already did in 11th class. So what is to, please note, in this a matrix is not directly given, but in terms of negative 1 means inwards. So first we have to move. How we can move? If I take this on the right hand side, then negative inverse becomes positive. So first we have to do it move. Now what we will put? 1 minus tangent x and 1, and move this side because it is in inverse. That's why I am moving this. What we will put? This as it is, cos 2x minus sin 2x multiply cos 2x, and this becomes 1 tangent x minus tangent x, which is equal to 1. Now we have to simplify. It means this is a single term, so it's very difficult to prove right hand side because we have to expand. But if we do this right hand side, we can easily prove, because if we do multiplication, then it becomes simplified and we get the desired result. That's why I am taking this term and prove this term. So firstly, what we have to do? I am taking our right hand sides. Our right hand side is what? Cos 2x, sin 2x, minus sin 2x, cos 2x, and here you can write as, again please make a note, if I remove this, it can also take it on first part. I am also taking it on this part also. Because it is here in first part. So if we move this, first we got 1 tangent x, then 1, and then this terms as it is, cos 2x minus sin 2x into cos 2x. You keep the order maintained. So I am solving this, 1 tangent x minus tangent x, 1, and this side is cos 2x sin 2x minus sin 2x and cos 2x. Now we have to solve this, and we get the desired result in terms of, this is our left hand side, means we have to get the result in terms of tangent x. But here we got the term sin x and cos x, then how we can do? You know, sin x, cos x, tangent x, all can be written as in terms of tangent x. We have an identity, most important. If you want to change all the terms sine, cos and tangent in terms of tangent x, then what's the identity? Please make a note. First identity is tangent 2x. What's the tangent 2x is? Which is equal to 2 tangent x divided by 1 minus tangent square x. Now what is sin 2x? Sin 2x is 2 tangent x, and this negative simply becomes positive. So we get 1 plus tangent square x. And what is cos 2x? Cos 2x is equal to 1 minus tangent square x upon 1 plus tangent square x. So we have to use this identity to change sine and cos in terms of sine or in terms of tangent x. We do the same thing here. 1 minus tangent x, tangent x 1. Now cos 2x is what? 1 minus tangent square x. Cos 2x is what? This 1 minus tangent square x divided by 1 plus tangent square x. What is sin 2x? Sin 2x is 2 tangent x upon me 1 plus tangent square x. Sin 2x again 2 tangent x divided by 1 plus tangent square x. Again cos 2x, we got 1 minus tangent square x upon me 1 plus tangent square x. Now the again question becomes very difficult because we get very complex expression. If we solve this, our multiplication becomes very difficult. So how we remove this difficulty? By replacing, by assuming. If I assume tangent x by some letter, then it becomes very easy to solve. Because if we do multiply in terms of tangent, then it becomes very tough. So I am assuming that tangent x is equal to, suppose, t. I am assuming tangent x is equal to t. Then the what's the expression becomes here? The expression becomes, I am writing here, it becomes very simple. 1, tangent x becomes t, and minus tangent x becomes minus t, and 1 as it is. Same here, 1 minus t square divided by 1 plus t square. This is minus 2t upon me 1 plus t square. Here same, 2t upon me 1 plus t square. Again same here, 1 minus t square upon me 1 plus t square. Now we have to solve this, and what we have to prove, I am writing here on this side because I am going to rub the whole portion. What we have to prove, our left hand side is what? Our left hand side is 1 minus tangent x, 1 minus tangent x, and tangent x 1. Sorry, 1 minus tangent x and tangent x into 1. This is which is we have to prove. So that's why I am right here and I am rubbing the whole portion. So make a note first. So I write this expression on this side and we have to prove this. This is our main purpose. Now what we have to do? Please make a note. 1 plus t square, 1 plus t square. All the terms, so we can take common. 1 minus t, t 1. If I am taking 1 upon me 1 plus t square common, then what I will call? 1 minus t square minus 2t, 2 into t, and 1 minus t square. So this is your scalar number, so we can move it on the left hand side. What's the result? 1 upon me 1 plus t square, and we got 1 minus t, t 1, and here we got 1 minus t square minus 2t, 2 into t, and 1 minus t square. Now solve this. 1 upon me 1 plus t square, 1 into this we get 1 minus t square, plus t into 2 square, we get 2 into t square. Now 1 into minus 2t, we get minus 2 into t. T into this, we get plus t minus t into cube. Now so minus t into 1, minus t, minus minus plus, we got t cube. 1 plus 2, 1 into 2t, we got 2 into t. Now solve this, minus t into this, we got plus 2 into t square. Now 1 into this, we got 1 minus t into square. Now solve this, वन अपॉन में वन प्लस टी स्क्वेयर. नाउ वन इज इट माइनस टी स्क्वेयर प्लस टू टी स्क्वेयर, वी गॉट प्लस टी स्क्वेयर. नाउ माइनस टी प्लस टू टी, वी गॉट टी प्लस टी क्यूब. माइनस टू इंटू टी प्लस टी, वी गॉट माइनस टी, एंड दिस टर्म इज इट माइनस टी क्यूब. नाउ टू टी स्क्वेयर माइनस टी स्क्वेयर, वी गॉट टी स्क्वेयर प्लस वन. I am writing this portion. What's the result we got? I am writing here 1 upon me 1 plus t square, 1 upon me 1 plus t square. Now 1 plus t square, if we take t common, then what we will got? 1 plus t square. Again, if I will take negative t common, it becomes 1 plus t square. Here is also 1 plus t square. It means if I divide by this, or if you will multiply this term with this term, what will be? 1 plus t square will cancel out with 1 plus t square. Or you can take common. If I will take common, then what will be the result? 1 plus t square, I am going to take common. I got 1 t minus t and 1. This becomes cancel out. We got 1 minus t t 1. And what is t? T is your tangent x. Then we have to finalize. We have to put t as a tangent x. We got 1 minus tangent x. Tangent x 1. This is our left hand side 1 minus tangent x. Tangent x 1. We prove this question. It's very very easy, but it has some difficult level in terms of your trigonometry. If you know the trigonometry identity, then such type of question becomes very easy. So please make a note first. Now I am going to take our next question, question number 22. Look at the question. Question becomes very tough. It's very lengthy. And how can we prove it's very challenging question? What the statement f of alpha is this? It means it is again in terms of trigonometric function. Now g of beta is this. Then we have to find f of alpha inverse, which is equal to f of minus alpha. It means if we find out f of alpha inverse, it's in terms of trigonometry, it's become very tough. Then we have to do for the beta case. Then third part is do also. We have to do first multiplication. Then we have to find the inverse. So it becomes very tough. And if we do step by step, then it go. I think it will be completed in our 7 or 8 page. Then how we will do this? It's very quick. We can do this by using the property. That's why I write the properties of the each inverse or any trigonometric function or whatever the matrix. You have to learn each property, because each property makes the question very easy. What the property? Please make a note. Our first property is what? If A into B is equal to B into A, which is equal to I, then what? I explained before it. A is called invertible matrix and B is called inverse of the matrix, means B is equal to A inverse. Please compare it. It means we have to find out one is inverse and second matrix. Same here, one is in terms of inverse and other is in terms of direct matrix. It means we have to use this. But in this we have to do multiplication of two matrix A and B. Then what will be the A and what will be the B? You have to do in this. One matrix is F of alpha and second matrix is F of minus alpha. So we are doing here. We already know F of alpha and we have to find F of minus alpha. And what will be? Replace alpha by minus alpha. We got cos of माइनस अल्फा माइनस साइन इंटू माइनस अल्फा जीरो, साइन माइनस अल्फा कोस माइनस अल्फा जीरो 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 वन, इट बिकम्स माइनस अल्फा इज इक्वल टू कोस ऑफ माइनस थीटा इज कोस थीटा, इट मीन्स द नेगेटिव ऑफ एंगल डज नॉट अफेक्ट द वैल्यूज ऑफ कोस थीटा, सो वी गेट कोस ऑफ अल्फा, बट वी नो साइन ऑफ माइनस थीटा इज माइनस साइन थीटा, अगेन नेगेटिव, सो नेगेटिव बिकम्स पॉजिटिव, वी गॉट साइन अल्फा जीरो, इट बिकम्स माइनस साइन अल्फा, इट बिकम्स कोस अल्फा, इट बिकम्स जीरो 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 वन, इट मीन्स वी गॉट एफ ऑफ अल्फा, we got f of minus alpha. Now we have to do multiplication and check is it possible or not. If it's this property is verified, then we can prove, otherwise we cannot prove. So f of alpha into f of minus alpha, we have to check what is f of alpha is cos of alpha sin of alpha 0 minus sin of alpha cos of alpha 0 0 0 1, and what is f of minus alpha is cos of alpha sin of alpha 0 minus sin of alpha cos of alpha 0 0 0 1. Now what we have to do, we have to do its multiplication, so please make a note first, then I will draw the whole matter. I am writing the whole portion here. F of alpha is this, F of minus alpha is this. We are doing multiply F of alpha into F of minus alpha. Now we got this. Now what we have to do? We have to do its multiplication. Do it yourself. We got cos into cos alpha, we got cos square alpha. Minus sine into minus sine, we got plus sine square alpha. 0 into 0 is 0. Cos alpha into sine alpha, we got cos alpha sin alpha, minus sin into cos, minus sin alpha into cos alpha. Now 0 into 0, 0. Now cos into 0, 0. Sin alpha into 0, 0. 0 into 0, 0. So we got 0. Now do second, sin into cos, sin alpha into cos into sin alpha into cos alpha. Now cos alpha into sin alpha, minus sin alpha into cos alpha, sin into sin, sin square alpha, cos into cos, cos square alpha. Now sin 0, cos into 0, 0 into 1, 0. Now 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 into 0, 0 into 0, 0, 1 into 1, 1, we got 1. Now what we got, please make a note. This term cancel out, this term cancel out, and sin square plus cos square theta is 1. So we got 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. It means we got an identity matrix. And what will be? B is what? In this case, I am taking f of minus alpha, or you can take other. You can make also, if you do B into A, then it means B is your invertible matrix and A will be the inverse of B. So in this, what we can write as our B is, in this case B is what? We can change the order also. F of alpha into F of minus alpha can be changed. I am writing here F of alpha into F of minus alpha, which is equal to f of minus alpha into f of alpha, which is equal to I. So it follows the same property. Then what I can write as f of alpha, or you can write as b is equal to f of alpha is what? Inverse of minus I alpha, or f of minus alpha is equal to f of alpha inverse, both of is true. But what we have to prove? We have to do proof. I hope this. Please make a note. We have to prove this. Same we have to do for g of beta. We have to first calculate g of minus beta, then do multiplication, we get identity matrix. The same case we can do same steps where you have to follow the all the steps are same. So please make a note first, then we will do our next part of this course. Now please make a look here. Now our second part is what? F of alpha into g of beta inverse, which is equal to this. We have to prove this. It is nothing. It is basically the result of the question 1. We already prove our first results. What we prove? F of alpha inverse. We already prove. What we prove? F of alpha inverse is equal to F of minus alpha. And g of beta inverse is equal to g of minus beta. And our left hand side is what? Our left hand side is f of alpha into g of beta. We have to find the inverse, and we know property a b inverse. If we do find out the inverse of multiplication of two matrix, then the order of the matrix will be changed. We got B inverse into A inverse. Same we have to do here. If we want to get the inverse, then what will be that inverse is G of beta inverse into F of alpha inverse. This is our equation 1 and this is equation 2. From equation 1 and 2, what it? G of beta inverse is what? G of minus beta. And what? F of alpha inverse is what? F of minus alpha. And we have to prove this. This is our what? Our right hand side. So second part is basically the extend version of the first part. I hope you understand the whole concept. So if you like my video, so don't forget to subscribe my channel Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes. If we can complete our exercise 5.2, then we will proceed to our next exercise 5.3 very soon. So please do like and share to it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching my video. We will meet as soon as possible.